musical talent in this room. What? This is crazy. I would like to welcome special guest, the No Reading Dixieland Band. Thank you for your time. They're here with us today because they use our space to rehearse. And so in the form of payment, they come and give us a show. I mean, they help lead us in worship throughout the year, which is wonderful. We're happy to do that. This church is committed to supporting music, and my friend, by the investment in our beautiful piano and sharing our space with these musical friends. So we're glad to have you here today. They're going to bring us music during the message time, and the last song that they do will be a sing-along, so we'll all get to join them. We begin our service of worship with prayers, joys, and concerns that you shared with me during the week or put on the sign-up sheets. Thank you, Noah, that you would hear us pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. All right. I like these kids being front and center like this. It's time for the children to come forward. Obed, ask Sam. Obed. Can you say that, Obed? Are you glad you didn't get named Obed when you were born?
Yeah.
Thank you.
this last piece will be a sing-along. They're going to give us a couple times through as an introduction, but when you see the words on the screen, feel free to join.
Are you in the corral then?
Bringing you joy like that, and think about it, because God gives you joy when you do use the talents you have to serve God. So I just thank you for sharing that joy. It's now time for our offering. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for the gifts and graces that you've given each one of us, from beautiful music to teaching and cleaning and accounting and all of those things that you do to make up a strong body. And we ask that this week when we serve you, that you would really give us a sense of joy.
We ask that you would receive this offering as an expression of thanks for the talents that you've given us. We ask that you would bless it and multiply it to your service in the world. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
There's no frivolous expenses in here or wasted expenses. There's no pastoral trips to Vegas or anything. And then on the income side of the house, the things that struck me here is, over the years through the combination of donations and some really outstanding fundraising, of which I can't list them all because I'm sure I'll forget and don't want to do that. But you'll see when you look at these sheets that through fundraising and through donations, we're continuing to increase the income of the church. The other thing and the last point that I'd bring up is all of us know the reality of living in this world, costs go up, right? No matter what we do, the expenses, the heat, the light, the phone bill, the water bill, et cetera, unfortunately goes up on us. So as a church, what we're asking folks to do this year, we have a goal of increasing our pledges by 5% to help us with the challenges of the increasing expenses. And we ask those that perhaps haven't pledged in the past, if you consider pledging, The one thing that pledging does for us as a church, it enables us to be better stewards of the money. Knowing the income in advance allows us to plan and to make better decisions and to make sure we're using every last dollar of the donations in the most appropriate way to help the church. So that's all I have, Rachel.
Thank you, Jeff. We have the slideshow again to remind us of the mission and ministry of the church over the last year.
October. We want to finish that project by doing the front porch of the house, and that's next Saturday, right, Kevin?
That's right.
It's at 9 a.m., so if you want to come swing a hammer or move trash, there's a lot of trash moving, I guess, or help make food. Joni Tarbox said she'd help make food, by the way. For that mission work on that day, it's coming up this Saturday, you can talk to Kevin. And related to that, we sell wreaths every Christmas time that go to benefit that mission up in Maine, the church here, and also pay a fair wage to the wreath maker. So we're in the middle of that wreath sale right now. After church, I will have cards for you. I would love it if you would talk to someone about what our church does. Tell them the story of us going up to Maine and helping out around here in North Reading as well with our construction ministry. And then sell them a wreath, because they're going to want to say yes to you, because they're going to be glad to hear about this work that the church is doing. The wreaths come in Thanksgiving weekend. So I will have those cards, and we appreciate your support in helping to sell those. Also, Kristen, announcement about the pageant?
Yes. Donna is supposed to be doing this. The first rehearsal for the Christmas pageant will be the Sunday right after Thanksgiving. I think it is already a sign-up sheet in the hall for the kids, but also any grown-ups that would like to lend a hand with the organization and actual execution. We'd love you to just throw your name on there too, contact Dawn Marie, or send her a message to me.
Yeah, so adults or kids interested. On the sign-up sheet it says you have to put your age, but adults don't have to put your age. that's great. Thank you so much for your leadership. I had a wonderful, wonderful story from Kristen and Dawn Marie were in Starbucks the other night, brainstorming about this pageant, getting so excited that people two tables over came over and I was like, what are you doing? Actually ended up being Methodist from Salem, Mass, and pray with you guys to encourage you for your leadership. And I just thought, fantastic. I love it. All right, celebration and thanks this week. I want to recognize those who worked at the breakfast, in particular those who jumped in towards the end so that the whole Spicer Morissette family could go and watch Noah run in his race. So thank you to all the breakfast helpers yesterday. Okay, if there's no other announcements, I invite you to enjoy the final piece from all of our musicians. We may dance, we're invited to dance.
Thank you.
Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the joy of serving God into the world go with you until we meet again. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.